Welcome to this ESN Smart Nitrogen virtual farming experience. Drag your mouse or tilt your handheld device for a 360-degree view of this field. Let's begin our plot tour of ESN on corn, cotton, and soybeans in northeastern Arkansas with Mike Howell.
Well, good morning. Thank you for coming to our field tour here in northeast Arkansas this morning. Today we're going to be talking about ESN, environmentally smart nitrogen, and the benefits it has to corn production here in the Delta area of the country. Nitrogen loss is really important to growers here in the Delta region. We can lose nitrogen from volatilization, we can lose nitrogen to leaching or denitrification. Wet conditions like we have here today, we're more worried about things like denitrification and leaching with this excess water.
Let's take a closer look at how ESN works to make your operation better. ESN technology uses a flexible polymer coating to encapsulate a nitrogen granule. The coating protects the N from loss mechanisms, releasing it when the crop needs it most. The membrane allows water to diffuse in, dissolve the N granule, and create a water and urea solution. The granule then releases nitrogen at a predictable rate, controlled by soil temperature. Now let's head back to the field to see how well ESN performs.
So in this location, we're actually evaluating ESN in two different trials. The field on my right is an ESN trial looking at different rates and timings, different rates and blends. We're looking at blends of 50%, 75%, and 100% ESN and comparing that to straight urea. We're looking at rates ranging all the way from 0 pounds of nitrogen, which you can see in the check plot here in front of me, all the way up to 300 total pounds of nitrogen. Typically what we see in these situations is about a 10 bushel yield increase from the ESN because it's protecting that nitrogen, allowing the nitrogen to be there later into the growing season when that crop actually needs it. I pulled 2 ears of corn here today. This is from a 300 pound plot with 75% of that nitrogen coming from ESN. This is 300 pounds of nitrogen coming from urea. You can see there's a big difference in the size of these ears here. It's been extremely wet in this part of Arkansas this year. We've had a lot of nitrogen loss primarily from denitrification in these plots, and that's why we're seeing these differences in the size of these ears today. The plot here on my left, we're evaluating different timings of application. Most growers are applying nitrogen 3 times in corn in this part of the country. They're putting out an application at planting. They're putting out a side dress application about V4, V5, maybe a little later. And then they're putting out a pre-tassel application to carry that corn all the way through the growing season. We're comparing that standard application to ESN applied 1 time or 2 times. And what we found in other studies is that ESN is able to protect that nitrogen and we can eliminate that third application in this corn crop. Cotton is a unique crop grown in the southern part of the United States. Cotton is actually a perennial plant that we're growing as an annual. So nitrogen management is really critical. If we apply too much nitrogen early in the year, we'll make this cotton grow vegetative. It'll get really tall and put a lot of leaves on, but we won't have any fruit. So nitrogen management is critical, and because of the ESN's controlled release technology, we're able to put out all of the nitrogen and not worry about the crop getting rank and having excessive vegetative growth. We actually have 2 trials today. The first trial is a rate comparison where we're looking at a 0 treated check compared to 30, 60, 90, 120, and 150 units of nitrogen. Now the nitrogen used in this study is coming from 2 different sources. The first is 100% urea. And then the second is 75% ESN, 25% urea. Now we've been conducting these types of trials across the cotton belt for about 10 years now. What we found when we look at all these trials averaged together, we're seeing about a 70 pound of lint yield increase when we're using the ESN compared to the grower standard practice. Now we also have a separate trial this year that we're looking at a timing of application study. We're looking at a single application of ESN applied at planting, comparing that to the grower standard practice for the area of a split application of urea applied at planting and then again at first square. Now typically when we have these applications applied in the past, we're able to find that ESN produces as good or higher yields than the split application of urea. So by using the single application, we're able to save the growers time, save them trips through the field, increased cost in putting out additional nitrogen. Because this nitrogen is protected by the unique polymer coating, it's protected against that nitrogen loss, allowing it to be in the field later into the season when the crop actually needs it. Now, soybeans are a little unusual to talk about nitrogen. Soybeans are a legume crop, which means that they are able to fix their own nitrogen from the atmosphere. Typically, under ideal conditions, a soybean can produce enough nitrogen to make a 60 to 80 bushel soybean crop. But many growers are looking for higher soybean yields these days. And with additional nitrogen, we may be able to get over that yield hurdle. Now, we've been doing soybean research across the United States for the past 5 or 6 years. And by applying ESN prior to the reproductive stage, we're able to find about a 7 bushel yield increase. Now, the way this works is because ESN is a controlled release nitrogen source, it's only putting out a little bit of nitrogen at a time. That doesn't trigger the nodules to quit producing their nitrogen. So the soybean plant is going to produce its own nitrogen until it gets to the reproductive stage, and then it converts that energy into setting the pods, making the beans that we're trying to harvest. So about the reproductive time is the time that the soybean needs the most nitrogen. So by applying this ESN about 2 weeks before it goes into the reproductive stage, we're able to increase the amount of nitrogen that's available to that plant, thereby increasing the yields on these soybeans. We're comparing conventional soybean systems, no added nitrogen, with ESN applied to the soybeans about 2 weeks prior to first bloom. And this is going on at a rate of about 70 pounds of nitrogen per acre. Now, we've been running these experiments across the United States for about 5 years now. When we see this, we see increased plant height, we see an increase in stalk diameter, as well as an increase in the number of four-bean pods on these plants. With all of that, we're also seeing a yield increase, on average about 7 bushels to the acre. And what that means to the grower is based on local soybean prices and the cost of ESN, it's going to result in about a $20 to $30 return on investment back to the grower. So for growers that are looking for that next yield level in soybeans, ESN is definitely a tool that can help increase those yields as well as increase the profits on those soybeans.
Thanks for joining us. We hope you enjoyed this ESN Smart Nitrogen virtual farming experience. Visit smartnitrogen.com for more information.